Professor Dr. Mool Chand Sharma. Professor Sharma has taught us jurisprudence while we were pursuing our law studies. He had been a member secretary for UGC, a full-time member for Law Commission. I present to you Professor Dr. Mool Chand Sharma.
I wish Honorable Justice Tucker was here, though I have already conveyed what I'm going to talk to you. He quoted a Urdu couplet of a teacher of Sri H.K. Dua, the secretary of Urdu Academy of Haryana. And the message he drew was that even if you speak right things at a wrong place, you might create a havoc. And then he elaborated right from Mr. Justice Kailash Gambhir to Sri H.K. Dua. They all elaborated this press conference of the four senior judges. Each one of them was this side as well as that side, because there was right but wrong place. And therefore I wish that couplet was told and brought to the notice of these four senior judges, and probably the entire episode and the entire syndrome of use, misuse, exploitation, blackmail of the judiciary through the impeachment could have been avoided. That's my first remark I want to make. The second remark I want to make is that when Honorable Sri H.K. Duaji says that every institution of the country is being targeted, is being demolished, I think it is in this arena, sir, it is at this point of time, protecting the judicial credibility, judicial acceptability, and judicial legitimacy is perhaps the most important thing. And I'll tell you why. Because please mark, if you go back to 17th century, when somebody called Brooke came out with the idea of how the parliament should function and how the government should function. And at that time, what he told was that the parliament can pull the crown. That means the legislature or the elected people can pull down the executive. This is how the governance should be given. Unfortunately, what a big U-turn in 2018 or 17, where what is happening? The government and the nation is being run by the executive through the parliament. I repeat what I'm saying, that today what is happening is that earlier it was the political executive which was responsible to the parliament. And now what happens? You have got the whip, you have got somebody in the jail, he decides the ticket, he decides how should you vote. Are you getting my point? And therefore what is happening? It is the executive which is running through the parliament. And I think that is a real, real syndrome of this country. We have to come out of that. That's my second thing, that unless the judiciary realizes and unless the nation accepts, and this becomes more biting, because you recall this entire debate that judicial overreach, judicial activism, judicial terrorism, this is being touted by whom? by the political executive through the parliament. You will be surprised when Chandrasekhar was the prime minister, at that time, two houses of the parliament met and passed a resolution. I will not use the word threatening, but they did mention to the judiciary, you should remain within your domain and don't cross your limits. Forget that. Again, during Manmohan Singh's regime, again two houses met, passed the same resolution. Again, both the houses met, passed Judicial Appointment Commission Act. Forget that. Again, a year and a half ago, both the houses met and they passed same resolution and in a way threatening the judiciary that you are overreaching and you should understand your limitation. Now, please mark, this all is happening. Why this all is happening? Because they are using this parliament as a platform to belittle, to demean the judiciary. And unfortunately, third thing which Honorable Justice Gambhir has said, that has given a chance to it. Because he said independence from outside and independence from inside. And he said right from Jayant Patil's case, the first case you mentioned, Justice Gambhir, was of Jayant Patil. And I need not elaborate what he said. The bottom line of his was what? That one day, the same collegium with same members make one recommendation, and the same collegium within few days or within few hours make altogether a different recommendation. Now, please mark, is it from inside or it is from outside? And therefore, it is very, very important that judiciary itself becomes careful and do not give chance to bring impeachment as a threat, to bring impeachment as a blackmail ground, and to instill a sense of fear amongst the judges. These are my three points which I will elaborate as I proceed. And please allow me, I think the organizer asked me to speak for about 30 minutes, and I'll try to remain confined to 30 minutes, rather little less. And if I cross, all right, I'll be little less.
We are used to 50 minutes of class, sir.
Oh, no, I'll be half of that, okay? I promise I'll be half of that. Now, please, minded here of something. What happened in America in 1832, Chief Justice Marshall decided a case. And when he decided a case, the case went like this, that non-native Indians, non-native Americans were not allowed to stay or go or travel or do any business at a place which is owned by American natives, right? And what happened? Chief Justice Marshall said, this is violation of equality, this is violation of freedom of speech, this is violation of freedom of expression, this is violation of association, and therefore this is bad. I stuck it down. Please mark, my story may go a little longer, but it's a great message to give. Because at that time, the president name was Andrew Jackson. He was a very, very hard conservative and Republican. When the judgment came, he gave the press conference. And please mark the press conference carefully. He told, all right, Justice Marshall has given the judgment. Let him now implement it. Because neither he has a purse, nor he has soured, Hamilton has said. So let him do whatever he wants to do. And not only this, he went to make a second sentence. I am born for a storm. I don't like to live in calm. I don't like to live in calm. I have been brought in storm, and I do not like to live in calm. Meaning thereby what? I will confront the Chief Justice. I will see to it how your judgment is implemented. I don't want to go into further detail that what happened, that the same Supreme Court somewhere in a school segregation case compelled the political executive to give free buses, to do free zoning. They did everything. Why? Because the sentence was not accepted literally. Judiciary came forward, exercised its power, and exercised. But to do that, what you require, judges should be objective, judges should be above biases, judges should be above partisanship, and more than that, and which is my main theme of today's talk, more than that, each institution, because each institution has been given birth by the Constitution, and each institution is there to promote, nurture, foster the Constitution. And if that is accepted, and which has to be accepted, because till today there is no executive, even when Mrs. Gandhi imposed the emergency, what she said, I have done according to Constitution. She might not have done, but she could not dare to say that I am doing unconstitutional. Whatever present government is doing, I am doing constitutional. They dare not say that they are doing unconstitutional. That means Constitution is a great tool, great weapon. It depends upon your creativity, your intelligence. How do you use? Do you speak right thing at a wrong place, or do you speak right thing at a right place? Do you behave one way in the collegium or another way in the collegium? Whether you want to send back Joseph's name today, or you want to send them along with seven other names and again give an opportunity of changing the seniority. I really don't know, because these are very, very serious questions. I have only one thing to say, and what is that? That apply outside as well as inside. You know, if rule of law, if democracy, if institutional integrity, sir, have to be protected, then each institution should realize that building a democratic nation, nurturing rule of law, is like honeycombing. From judge one to judge four, what happened? I will occupy your space. I will not allow you to take space. That means I will either usurp your space, or I will force you to leave your space, or I will tempt you to surrender your space. If this happens, do you think honeycombing can take place? Do you think with this kind of confrontational attitude, do you think with this kind of egoistic? No. Honeycombing takes place how? One bee comes, allows another bee also to come, allows third also to come, allow fourth also to come. They jointly take an exercise, and this is how honeycombing comes. And unfortunately, in this country, what is happening? This entire game of ego, entire game of confrontation, entire game of mistrust, that is happening. That is what creating the problem. That's my one issue. And I very humbly, strongly appeal, when Justice Vijender Jain said from here that these kind of meetings should be held more oftenly and more in a place like this where there are all kind of people, it is important that this opinion carries the weight. It is this opinion we should compel the judiciary as well as the political executive to follow a culture of honeycombing rather than fighting with each other. See, the success of PIL resided where? It resided because the executive, the judiciary, the media joined together. Once they fell apart, once the media started playing a populistic game, the problem came. Once the lawyers started playing their political game, the problem came. But otherwise, honeycombing brought you result. It is honeycombing which brought you the result of forgetting that dark days of the emergency. And therefore, I strongly plead that there has to be honeycombing. That is one. Two, same kind of honeycombing internally also is needed in the judiciary. Because what these four judges did, I'm no one here, and I'm open for contempt of court, but I think that this kind of platform and where free and fair expression of view, you may not like my view, that's a different part of Sui, but I should be given the chance to speak my say, and I strongly say that these four people, they might not be having that intention. They might be having correct intention, right? But they played in the hands of the political executive. And how they played in the hand of the political executive? That by saying that democracy is in danger. You are not elected people. Who are you to assess that democracy is in danger? Please don't make a statement for which you may be right. You know, that is what Justice Thakkar said. When you are alone, thought should govern you. When you are in public, word should govern you. And therefore, what happened? Whatever was your thought, you spoke in a manner which only a politician should speak, and not you should speak. And what you created? You created an harakari. And what you created in harakari? You gave the chance to people like Honorable Justice Gambhir, to people like Manish Chhibbar, to people like Shekhar Gupta, to come out with what? All instances of internal bickering within what? Within the collegium. And therefore, what happened? What happened? Great mistrust and distrust within the member of the collegium grew. And therefore, it is very important that if honeycombing between various institutions is needed, honeycombing between these judges is also needed. And it is very, very important that there are two classes now, even within the judiciary. Sir, it is not only the bickering in collegium. There is something more sinister which is happening, which is something which is very distasteful which is happening. And what is that? That those judges who are the member of the collegium, they think they are the super class. Supreme Court is one institution. Each judge has a one vote. Are you appreciating my point? And therefore, what happens is, because I happen to be a member of collegium, and therefore I assume that I am the kingmaker. God knows who is the kingmaker in Karnataka today. But what happens is that I am the kingmaker. And therefore, what you do, all judges in the High Court who are in the pipeline to become the judges, right, you become most darling of there, and you love to be darling of there. And therefore, you ignore your own colleagues. That gives a lot of heart burning. That creates a stratification even within the court. And therefore, it is very, very sad. You know, half of these bickering which have been brought here are precisely because of that. Because this sunrising syndrome is only because of that. Because what happens is, I keep on approaching these four judges because they are important to me. They are important to me. Please see when they alight from the aeroplane, who are the people who come to receive them there? You know, fortunately or unfortunately, I have worked in Supreme Court also for a few years. And I worked in the Supreme Court at the time, which was the best of the times. And I don't call that this is the worst of the time. Worse under the Constitution. None is allowed to violate the Constitution. And if that is the common objective, and that is what the directive principle directs all of them, if that is the common objective, then you are violating that common objective. If you are usurping the power of other, or you are insulting the other, or humiliating the other, or tempting the other. That attitude is needed. That is the hour of the day. Thank you very, very much. Thank you.